In 2009, following the extrajudicial killing in police custody of Muhammad Yusuf, the then leader of the Boko Haram group, what followed was incessant attacks on policemen and other security personnel, and the burning down of police stations in some parts of the Northeast, particularly in Borno and Yobe states. At that time, not many people were worried so far. It was only the police and the security agencies that were being attacked. The belief then was that those attackers were expressing genuine grievances because of the extrajudicial killing of their leader. Nobody knew that a monster was being created or worse in the making. But as time went by, the attackers began to escalate. The attacks began to escalate to assume higher dimension and spread into many other places. In the process, many people were gunned down or kidnapped as the entire Northeast zone was engulfed with the insurgency. Soon, the whole country was caught up with the Boko Haram, which resulted to several killings, kidnappings, and burning down of both private and public properties. 11 years down the line, Nigeria, even with the assistance from the international community, is still battling hard to contain the Boko Haram insurgency. To no avail. In the past few months, we are beginning to witness similar things that happened in the north, especially the northeast, rearing their ugly heads in the southeast geopolitical zone, such as frequent attacks on police stations and killing of policemen. Every day we hear stories that one police station or the other has been attacked, and that some policemen have been killed. From our reckoning, there were no less than 30 police stations that have so far been burnt or destroyed in the southeast. These few months, while over three dozens of policemen were killed, we are disheartened. Instead of abating, the attacks are continuing in intensity, for instance. Just as we were recovering from the news of the recent attacks on the police headquarters in Owerri, Imo State, and the Owerri Correctional Prison, where over 1,800 inmates were freed, we got another disturbing news that the Zone 13 police headquarters in Upor, Dunukufia local government area of Anambra State had been attacked. We were dismayed. Reported attacks by some unknown gunmen on police formations in the southeast and the killing of policemen on duty have become a pastime and assuming alarming and dangerous dimensions these days. No day passes without report of any such ugly incident. This is worrisome. Perhaps not many people would appreciate the possible consequences of this new development. Presently, we observe that most roads in the southeast have been deserted by policemen, and that police checkpoints have also suddenly disappeared from roads in the area. While many people may be rejoicing about this development because they no longer have to roger any policeman on the road, our fear, however, is that very soon the southeast may likely be at the mercy of criminal elements. Anytime they want to strike, even if in the past we feel that the police were not doing as much as we expected, or that they were not performing to our satisfaction, their presence on the roads, at least, were enough to scare away some bad boys. Now, with their complete desertion from the roads, there surely would be no restraint for whoever wants to do some dirty job in the Southeast. It will certainly be a walkover. You can imagine what happens if there is no policeman, or sorry, if there is no police station in the entire Southeast. How will the people be dealing with some criminal elements like armed robbers, kidnappers, rapists, cultists, burglars, pickpockets, arsonists, etc.? It will certainly be a field day for them. Nobody knows who is behind this incessant burning down of police stations in the Southeast and the killing of policemen. Some people would easily point their fingers towards the direction of IPOB and the Eastern Security Network. But supposing it is the handiwork of ordinary criminals and bandits masquerading as freedom fighters, some other people would suggest that the attackers might have come from outside Igbo land and sponsored to cause trouble in the Southeast, so as to find reason to invade and attack the area. We do not know who actually is responsible, but it calls for urgent investigation. When all the police stations in the Southeast might have been completely burnt down or destroyed, and policemen in the area scared off our roads, the criminals or enemies of the Southeast would have the liberty to begin to pounce on the people anyhow they wish, and there would be no one to protect or defend them. No matter how bad any government might be, the citizens can never be assured of their safety without law enforcement agencies to regulate the activities of various elements in the society. Otherwise, it would be a descent into anarchy, chaos, and lawlessness, as in the Hobbesian state of nature, where life was short, nasty, and brutish. In other words, the people of the Southeast cannot do without the existence of the police and other security agencies. Whether they are performing to our satisfaction or not. Because to do otherwise would be self-destruct. No society ever depends on non-state actors for its security and defense. Because without a government regulatory instrument, everything will be turned upside down. All the same, we are not impressed with the way our security operatives in the Southeast cheaply and cowardly abscond or run away from their duty posts each time they were attacked. They knew that they were not going on a dinner party when they applied and got enlisted into the force. Therefore, they should not easily give in, but return fire for fire. Each time they are attacked, to stoutly defend themselves and protect their formations. In standard international practice, the security outfits and operatives are statutorily obligated to defend their formations, even if they were to pay the supreme sacrifice. As a better trained and better equipped group, the security operatives in the Southeast should hold their ground and not succumb or chicken out each time they were attacked. They should rise to the challenge of defending themselves and the law-abiding citizens in the Southeast. All right, guys, what are your thoughts concerning this particular news story? As it were, you've heard it all. This is the situation of things right now as we speak. That is the situation of things. It is unfortunate. It is saddening, but it is the truth of the matter. Well, drop by at the comment section. Let's know what your thoughts are. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Please kindly hit the bell icon so you can get notification whenever we post new stories. Endeavor to share these new stories with your friends, family, relations, and loved ones so they can get to know what is happening around the world and be informed. Thank you so much, guys. I appreciate your support, and I'll see you on the other news. Thank you, and bye for now.